was solutions. And I, because if we're aware of this program, if we're aware of what the globalists are doing, then people politically can stop it and understand the grand design by having the blueprint. And normally when Lindsay gets new information, you know, he puts it out on a CD. It's quicker than a book. His book's out of print or a DVD, but that takes a few weeks to produce. And normally when he's ready, he calls me because now he's ready to get the information out. But I happened to call him right when he'd gotten this information. But he's going into production next week on this. And it's going to break down all these new developments. And I'm told the name is going to be the new DVD video, The Middle East, The Rest of the Story, that's going to be in production over the weekend. He's going to rush out with the great folks at the Prophecy Club, prophecyclub.com, and get that out. And I asked Lindsay this morning, because obviously folks want to will want to have this, to show it to people, to share it. There'll also be the archive video of this interview, and it'll be on YouTube and everywhere else. But if you want just Lindsay breaking it all down in even more detail, I mean, is it okay now to tell folks that they could call and pre-order it if they wanted to, Lindsay? Or is, I know the Prophecy Club's a big outfit.
They can pre-order right now if they wish. You can either call our toll-free number, or you can go to the website and pre-order. And in the order that the orders are received, we will ship out the moment that the editing has been done on the DVD and DVD and the VCR. We're going to have both available to you as a unit.
Okay, so that's Prophecy Club. That's prophecyclub.com. And do you happen to have the number in front of you?
888, toll free, 888-799-6111. And you'll hear an American operator.
And we will give that out again before you leave us. We're going to be going into some overdrive today, into the fourth hour. We're again honored to have Lindsay Williams here with us. I want to get to calls and not shortchange them. Lindsay, finishing up with the time frame, you said they're going to rise China up. Then they're going to start the exploration here in the next few years. Then you're going to see a big decline in the U.S. As they suck everything out of the economy. Everything is based on petrol, based on oil, and this is going to be a vertical integration, a consolidation of wealth. But then your source said that later they're going to build the U.S. back up. What's the time frame on that?
I did not give a time frame on that. It'll all depend on how they're able to open up what they want to open up, the advancement of China. Keep in mind that if it's written on a piece of paper, it's worth the paper it's written on. And this is the way that they will double-cross the Arabs. Remember also that George Bush Sr., Daddy Bush, was the ambassador to China prior to that time. Please go back and look this up and get some information on it. Research it for yourself. I don't have time to give it today, though we'll do a whole section on this. George Bush Sr., Daddy Bush, the great Mr. New World Order, was the ambassador to China from the United States of America years ago. Prior to his being ambassador, China was a closed society. The Great Wall of China divided them from everybody, and China did not do business with the outside world. George Bush Sr., Daddy Bush, opened up China to the world and made it the great power that it is today, and he was the first one to announce that there would be a new world order.
And the globalists have done everything they can to position the industry, the power, to have China be the owner of our debt, teamed up with the private Federal Reserve, the second biggest owner. And now, we covered it earlier, if you guys can find that AFP or AP headline, China secretly using influence on the SEC, on the Treasury Department, on the federal government to let them buy up U.S. companies, to let them create oligopolies, to have the SEC leave them alone, to allow them to basically buy this country up. There's AFP. Cables show China used debt holdings to press U.S. Leaked diplomatic cables vividly show China's willingness to translate its massive holdings of U.S. debt into political influence on issues ranging from Taiwan sovereignty to Washington's financial policy dealing with Chinese companies in the U.S. And it just goes on and on and on. I mean, this is the globalist plan. We've been made dependent. We're being taken over. Is this not high treason by the globalist, Lindsay?
It positively is. And the thing that the average American doesn't realize is that when we moved our industry to China, for instance, General Motors, whom you, as a taxpayer, bailed out in the United States of America. They were bankrupt. General Motors and Chrysler, you bailed them out. General Motors will sell more automobiles in China this year than they sell in the United States of America. Now, what happens when General Motors, Chrysler, Caterpillar, the biggest one on the New York Stock Exchange, Caterpillar, whenever these companies move to China and build these multi-million dollar, billion dollar plants, do you realize that the agreement with China is that, yes, we'll let you come to China, yes, we'll give you cheap labor, but you must give us all of your patents. Did you hear this? Boeing, when they moved to China, they had to give all of their patents. Their patent rights.
Well, Clinton gave them, along with Rumsfeld, when he was in private companies in the mid-90s, the ICBM secrets, the submarine-launched Trident secrets. This is a total sellout. Now, we've got Muhammad in the Middle East, and I want to go to him here in just a moment and other callers. But, Lindsay, this is too. I promise to go to calls. I'm going to have to get you back up sometime this week or next week
Alex,
to talk
really,
about solutions.
Yeah, really, I have only covered a fraction. I mean, I haven't even told of the time that Ken Fromm was fired because of my book, Energy Non-Crisis. I haven't even dealt with the only person that ever told this story apart from me, which was, by the way, please go and research this. In American Opinion, back in 1980, Alan Stang came to Alaska after Ken Fromm had been fired. Ken was so mad that he gave him everything. It's the only time it's ever been written, and he called him horse's mouth. And then what happened after that? Read the book, The Three Sisters. I mean, we've even skimmed the surface.
And you
today.
Got Fromm to go on stage at a public event in California. The oil execs, the CEO and another came in and sat down, totally freaked Fromm out. See, this has all been on record. He just didn't want you to get into it publicly with the new info. Now that he's died, you can. It's just so incredible. But let's go to phone calls. Let's talk to Brother Rakal in Cairo, Egypt. And we've confirmed his number. That's where he's calling from. Mr. Rakal, tell us what's going on.
How you doing, Alex? It's good to be talking to you. I've been a long time listener while I was in the States. How are you doing today?
I'm good. So what are you witnessing there in Cairo, and what's your view on what Lindsay Williams is talking about?
Well, let me say this. I want to say this to all the people in the States. If they didn't know, you got almost 100,000 Americans living in Egypt and frequently visit Egypt. And I'll say this. Not one American was harmed, a citizen, none of us. And it was surprising to hear the families who were concerned about their people, the way America was portraying what was happening in Egypt. And I want to say this, Alex. I want to go into what the Egyptians are saying here.
Yeah, do the Egyptians know this is a staged event?
Absolutely. Let me tell you, Alex, the Egyptians know nothing about a group called the Muslim Brotherhood. They know nothing of this. A matter of fact, they say it's like CIA or American. Okay? That's number one. Number two, I would like to say this to all the people out there. The majority of people who was in this so-called Liberty Square, the majority of these people, Alex, had no idea about a revolution. They was invited there they were busted, paid to go there. And if you know, if you ever frequent the Middle East, you'll know that these Arab people who are family, they frequent places together. They'll be outside all day, hundreds at a time. So it's nothing to get a few thousand people in a square.
No, they said millions, and it was 50,000, according to experts that looked at the crowd. But Google admits they were there for the CIA. They admit that they sent an al-Baradei the week before it all started. Again, we're not saying Mubarak was good. The point is, they are admittedly overthrowing it as the first domino, as we said a month ago, to put the Middle East in fire. So the Egyptian people know what's going on.
Hey, another thing I want to bring out, Alex, and you're right on there, and I want to say this, Alex. One thing that the Western world is not saying about Mubarak is the fact that there's many Egyptians who wanted Mubarak to stay. I'll tell you this. Mubarak is staunchly against the eugenics program and have been on record for this.
No, they got mad at him in the early 90s when he wouldn't start sterilizing people.
Exactly. And the babies are healthy there. The people are healthy there. And I'll tell you, the water is not the cleanest in the world, but these people are fairly healthy compared to any other people in the Western world. I'll tell you this, they're very family-oriented. And on top of that, there's another thing that people didn't know there. And it surprised me while I was here, Alex, is that there's many Americans, after leaving the military, come to the Middle East, get contracts, and work within the military, make big money over there. And Americans come over and actually work under these people in the Egyptian military. So there's a lot of facets to this that a lot of brothers and sisters and yourself, you're right on point. For you not to be in the Middle East, you may have some good contacts because you're not in the Middle East, and obviously you're able to articulate what's going on even in the Middle East. But I want to say this. Americans have no idea what's going on the outside of America, and you don't know until you go someplace.
No,
else.
Exactly. But any comments on what Lindsey Williams is saying?
A matter of fact, I want to thank Lindsey because the last thing he said is key. The last thing he said about what's going on with the oil and how they're going to double cross them and. Let me tell you, all the Egyptians and the other Middle Easterns knew that it was staged, and now they're starting to realize that they were props in America and the Western world's game. And it's not going to end out like they think it is. These people have some level of integrity and fight in them. And I'll tell you, when they find out that they were used, it's going to be all-out anarchy on another level, and I don't think the Western world can control it.
All right. No, I certainly, the dominoes were already there of folks being angry. Now they've triggered it. Google, I mean, here is on record, and now Google just admits they're this government front. It is so incredible. Thank you for the call, Brother Recall from Cairo. Lindsey Williams, your comments on what he was saying.
Well, I am so glad that he confirmed the fact that the Arabs realize they are going to be double-crossed. They aren't double-crossed yet. The big double-cross has yet to take place whenever the dollar collapses and they lose all the paper that they've invested in for many, many years, and they become literally paupers overnight.
And to be clear, this is going to double-cross Americans and others, but we see China and others moving away from the dollar right now. But your source is saying end of 2012, the dollar is going to not be the world reserve currency. What else did he say about that? Any specifics?
Yes, by the end of 2012, you'll see this double-cross with the OPEC oil-producing countries. They, in turn, will literally become enraged with America. The caller just from Egypt was exactly right. America will not be able to control it. Our president has made some drastic mistakes.
But that's part of the plan, is enraging them. That way the oil gets shut off.
That's exactly right. And then the price of crude oil will be up to $200 a barrel so that the oil companies, the elite of the world, as I call them, can become... You think they're rich now. You haven't seen anything. Wait until oil gets to $200 a barrel, and they produce it from America.
Oh, it's a giant tax directly to the globalists. It's a giant tax directly to the globalists. It's incredible. Damon in South Carolina, you're on the air with Lindsey Williams. Go ahead.
Hey, how's it going? I've got a couple of quick points to make to you. First of all, I was just over in Europe, flew over to the former Soviet Union, Republic of Belarus, stopped by in Austria along the way. Gas there, get this, okay, is 12.95 euros a liter, okay, which was all going down with the Egyptian crisis. That's over $18 American for a liter of gas over there. And gas has always been more expensive over there anyways, but that's going to go through the roof when that happens. And in Belarus, it was twice as much for a liter.
Well, Damon, I don't mean to interrupt you. I'm going to put you back on hold. We're going to skip this network break, so stations should carry it. I misunderstood. We had two callers from the Middle East, not just Brother Recall from Cairo, but Muhammad.